So we are about to start chapter 2, which is the time independent Schrodinger wave equation. And you know the Schrodinger wave equation was minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over d x square plus v psi is equal I h bar and d psi by dt. If it is only your wave function is only in one dimension, then I can write like this. For in a situation when our wave function will be other variable dependent like y, z as well, we will write minus h bar square over 2m curly psi over curly x square plus v of x psi, and this is equal I h bar curly psi over curly t. So it's only the difference of the partial derivatives in full derivative. Okay, now if our wave function big psi is a function of space and time, then I can write this thing is small psi of x and phi of t. Like I write this wave function in terms of two other wave functions, which is psi and phi. But psi only depends on position, means space, and phi depends on time. So in this situation, I will write that what about if I find the derivative of this with respect to time? So curly by curly t of this big psi is equal, what it will be? This will be a constant, the small psi, and it will be equal to curly phi by curly t. And if I want to find out the derivative with respect to space, means the spatial derivative of this big psi, then this is equal, this will be constant for it, and this will be equal to curly psi over curly x. And if I find a double derivative of this, then this will become curly square and this will become curly square. Similarly, this will become curly square, means another derivative of this, our second derivative of this. Now you are having this and this relation, so go back to your equation and you can write your equation minus h bar square over 2m, and then curly square big psi I will write now, and curly x square plus v of psi, and this is equal I h bar and curly big psi over curly t. Now put these values. For big psi, put this value here, and then for big psi here, put this value, because we have calculated these values earlier. And when I put these values, then I can write that minus h bar square over 2m. And what this value is equal to? This is equal to phi and curly square psi over curly x square plus v. This one is also big psi. So I can write v, and for big psi, I can write small psi and phi, right? Is equal to I h bar, and for this one, I can write small psi and curly phi over curly t. This technique we call the separation of variables, because we were having two variables. One was the space and the other time. So we split them into space and time. Our main wave function was a position of x and t. Now these wave functions are actually the space dependent and time dependent, and they are two. So now I can write this thing is, if I divide this thing, divide by big psi, or I divide this thing by small psi and phi, then what I will get? Minus h bar square over 2m, this is a constant. Now when it will divide by psi and this, so one, this will cancel with this, and one over psi will come in here. And curly square psi over curly x square plus v, and this is equal because both of them will cancel with this I h bar, and this will become 1 over phi and curly phi by curly t. This is equal to this, and now I can write that this equation is equal to this equation. Now when 2 means on this side you are having a function, and on this side you are having a function, means one function is equal to the other function. We have now split it. This side is all space because this is x portion, and this side is all time. So space is equal to time. Our one function is equal to another function. Now how you do treat such a situation mathematically? When one function is equal to another function, then it is not necessary that all of the terms of this function, because function is having how many terms in it? When you expand a function, it is having infinite number of terms in it. So individually all the terms will not be equal, but the sum of all the terms here will be equal to the sum of all the terms here in a function. So how we equate a function? We equate a function like this, that if this side is equal to a constant, if this side is equal to a constant, then this side will also be equal to the same constant, right? If this side is equal to something, then this side will also be equal to the same thing. Let's say I call this constant as E, and we know that this E is actually energy. So this side will also be equal to this one. When both are equal, then you can write that this and this are equal. So I can write that minus h bar square, minus h bar square over 2m, 1 over psi, and curly square psi over curly x square plus v is equal to E. And I can further write that IH bar 1 over phi and curly phi over curly t is equal to E as well. Now first take the time dependent function. As you convert this one, as you convert this one into separate, you can say space and time, then you can write that this partial derivative will go to full derivative. So 1 over psi and d square psi over dx square plus v is equal to E. This is your equation 1, and IH bar 1 over phi and d phi over dt is equal to E. This is your equation 2. So the partial derivative you will replace with the full derivative. Now, equation 2 implies that I can write, if I move this one to the other side, right? If I move this one to the other side, then I can write the d phi over dt. This is equal to, it will come out to be 1 over I h bar. So 1 over I h bar, I can write that this is minus I over h bar, right? And then it will be e times phi. Can I write like this? Because this will become 1 over I h bar. Now if I multiply it with minus and divide by minus. So this one, this minus I will write as I square, and 1 I will simplify with this, so I can write like this. Or you keep one thing in mind which is very simple. If you shift I from here to up, then it will become minus I. That is very easy to remember. So this is equal to this. And now, can you find phi from this one? I think it is very easy now to, if you integrate both sides, integrating both sides, then this will become phi of t, and this will become, because this dt will go here, and minus I over h bar, and e is also here, because e is a constant, and then phi and dt. Clear? So this thing will be equal to, this thing will be equal to what this dt will give. It will give t. So you will have that phi of t is equal to e power minus I t, or you can do it like this as well, that it is also very easy if you do it like this, means you reshuffle this one, is means this is very easy to do like this, that you write that phi here, 1 over phi, and d phi is equal minus I e over h bar and dt. So this is very easy to do. You integrate both sides. Then this side is equal to log of phi. This side is equal to minus I e h bar t. Now here is log and here is minus I e t by h bar. You take exponential of both sides. Then this will become phi of t, and this will become e to the power minus this. So this implies that phi of t is equal to e to the power minus I e t over h bar. And this will also have some, when you will integrate this thing, then it may have some constant, and that constant will come here. So this multiplied with C, any constant, and that constant for the moment we say that it is equal to 1. So I can write that phi of t is e to the power minus I a t over h bar. This is equation 3. And now I can write that psi x of t means the big psi that we were having, we defined here, is equal to psi of x. We haven't solved for psi of x yet, but this one will be equal to psi of x, and phi of t we have found, that phi of t is e to the power minus I e t over h bar. Is in our solution, one of, means this solution is yet remaining. So the constant which will come with this I will write here. But for the moment, forget about the constant. But your wave function comes out to be exponentially decaying function with time. It is an exponentially decaying function with time. This is space and this is time. So your psi of x is equal to this. Now, another equation that we will have to solve is equation 1, in which we are more interested. And why we are solving equation 1? One thing, that equation 1 is independent of time, because the time portion was with the equation 2 and it is here. This one will be time independent, and whenever you are having something time independent, you call it stationary states, right? So the next is that why do we want to find the solution of equation 2? Why do we want to find the solution of equation 2? Because it will give us stationary states. So the very first thing is that these are stationary states because the probability means the wave function is independent of time, so its probability will be independent of time. Because the probability is independent of time, we call such states as stationary states. Because you can see here that, what about this one? If I take capital Psi mod square, then it will be equal to capital Psi conjugate into capital Psi. It will be like this. Now capital Psi is here, so it will be equal to the small Psi conjugate, and this one will become plus. So e to the power I e t over h bar, and then Psi again, and e to the power minus I e t over h bar. Now you know these two are cancelling, and capital Psi mod square comes out to be the small Psi mod square, and this Psi is only a function of space, only a function of position. So it means the probability is independent of time. These are such states which don't depend on time. With time they remain the same, and such states we call stationary states. Okay, just like standing waves. Standing waves are also stationary states. So we can now write, and this will be true for all of, you can say, the measurements. For example, we do a measurement of momentum, then these things will cancel out there as well. If we do measurement of position, then these will cancel out as well. So as they are canceling out, so we say that our wave function is not affected by this.